cause it shows. I got a feeling there's a miracle due, gonna come true, coming to me. It's only just down the block, round the beach, soon as it shows. Something's coming, it's gonna be great, gonna be grand, catch the moon, one-handed catch. The air is humming, and something great is coming. Who knows? Round the block, down the beach, soon as it shows. Maybe tonight, maybe
Scholarship pageant. Something very exciting is indeed coming. The selection of a new Miss Kentucky and the awarding of over $3,800,000 in educational scholarships. Excitement is in the air. All of our Miss Kentucky contestants are waiting in anticipation. Could it be something is coming?
Tonight, some of Kentucky's most intelligent, talented, and beautiful young women compete for over $38,000 in educational scholarships and the opportunity to represent this state in the 1997 Miss America pageant.
Good evening. My name is Rachel Jo Rogers. I'm a senior at Morehead State University and Miss East Kentucky.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Terry Beth Bivens, a senior at Western Kentucky University, Miss Western Kentucky.
Good evening. I am a graduate of Indiana University. I am Claudia Coffey, Miss Jefferson County.
Good evening. My name is Tiffany Diller, a senior at Kentucky State University, Miss Pride of Kentucky State University.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. A sophomore at Murray State University, I am Shanna Carey Moore, Miss Louisville.
I'm Tanya Michelle Ramsey, Miss Cumberland Falls.
A graduate of the University of Kentucky, I am Brooke Robinson, Miss Paducah Area.
Good evening. A senior at the University of Kentucky, Kentucky. I am Tracy Jo Carpenter, Miss Fayette County.
Hello, a proud sophomore of the University of Kentucky. I am Whitney Boyles, Miss River City.
Good evening, a senior at the University of Kentucky. I am Andrea Burton, Miss Green River Valley.
Good evening, I'm Delana Hall, a senior representing Miss Moorhead State University.
Good evening, a graduate of Eastern Kentucky University, I am Dana Agee, Miss Richmond Area.
Good evening, freshman at Moorhead State University, I am Ann Nicole Gibson, Miss Milwaukee County.
Good evening, a freshman at Georgetown College, I am Natalie Whitlock, Miss Commonwealth.
Good evening, a senior at Georgetown College, I am Robin Littrell, Miss Monticello.
Good evening, a senior at the University of Kentucky, I'm Ginger Orvis, part of the Bluegrass.
Good evening, I'm Nathan Master, freshman at Kentucky Community College, and I'm Miss Grace, part of the Clark.
Good evening, a junior at the University of Kentucky, I'm Elizabeth Bitten White, Miss Derby City.
Good evening, a freshman at the University of Kentucky, I am Suzanne Sowards, Miss Lake Cumberland.
A graduate of the University of Kentucky, I am Rebecca Ann Nunley, Miss Lexington.
Good evening, a sophomore from Randolph-Macon Women's College, I am Sarah Jean Wagoner, Miss Belle of the River Cities.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm a graduate of the University of Cincinnati. I am Heather Renee French, Miss Jefferson Town.
Good evening. A junior at Alice Floyd College. I am Amy Chaffins, Miss Knott County.
Good evening. A sophomore at the University of Kentucky. I'm Rebecca Joan Bargo, Miss Willie County Fair.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Stephanie Arlene Reimer, a senior at the University of Kentucky, and I am Miss Bluegrass Area.
Good evening, everyone. A senior at Eastern Kentucky University, I'm very proud to be Miss Southeast Kentucky. My name is Cheryl Lynn Cook.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Lisa Collins. I'm a junior at Kentucky State University, Miss Central Kentucky.
Good evening. A graduate of Moorhead State University, I am Jill Crowley, Miss Shelby County.
Good evening. A graduate student at Marshall University, I am Lori Linden's house, Miss Ashland Area.
A student at Lexington Community College, I am Stephen Taylor Vaughn, Miss Campbellsville.
Well, let's hear it. There they are, one of these 30 young ladies will soon become Miss Kentucky 1997.
This year, Veronica Duca has made a lasting impression on thousands of Kentuckians. She was honored to be in the top 10 at the Miss America pageant last September. She's been very busy as the Kentucky Department of Agriculture's official spokesperson, speaking to thousands of school children about no ifs, ands, or buts. It's the law, teens and tobacco. She has received many letters from students, parents, and school principals thanking her for being a positive role model. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Kentucky, Veronica Marie Duca.
Don't go away. We're going to be back in just a moment with the announcement of our top 10 semifinalists vying for the title of Miss Kentucky 1997.
You know, the great thing about an Arby's roast beef sandwich is that it gives you a chance to express yourself. How you add your sauce to Arby's roasted beef is a very individual thing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
How you dab, how you split them. expression can be.
Okay, thrill seekers. So you do the do, but you haven't been there or done that until you've done this. Bring any Mountain Dew can to Kentucky Kingdom and get $10 off the price of general admission. That's $10 off all the great thrills, including Shag, the world's longest, tallest, fastest stand-up roller coaster. So go ahead, do the do. Then do bring in those empty cans and save $10 at Kentucky Kingdom, the thrill park.
Let me wrap you in my warm and tender love. Wrap you in my warm and tender love.
For dishes that come from the heart, they'll do the most small and creamy. Why cook with anything else?
You'll be mine.
They'll do that.
Let me wrap you in my warm.
It's made to melt. Chevy Blazer, with the exclusive driver control system, a little security in an insecure world.
Of course the academics are great, but outside the classroom it's many, many more.
I'll have what it takes to compete in today's workplace.
Agbert's commitment to spiritual life brings faith and learning together.
Why not check into it? Call Asbury College at 1-800-888-1818.
Welcome back, everyone. Our contestants have been in Lexington all week preparing for tonight's finals. Each of our contestants has met with a panel of judges for their 12-minute private interview.
And on Thursday and Friday night, each contestant competed on stage in the preliminary evening wear, talent, and physical fitness in swimsuit competition.
Tonight, 10 women who've received the highest number of total points are the 10 semifinalists, and of course, will continue on in tonight's competition. The auditing firm of Crane, Cohen, Sagesser, and Buston have computed the points, and our 10 semifinalists are now in. And in no particular order, contestant number 16, Ginger Orr, Miss Heart of the Bluegrass. Contestant number 20, Rebecca Nunley, Miss Lexington. Contestant number 15, Robin Litzel, Miss Monticello. Contestant number 3, Claudia Coffey, Miss Jefferson County. Contestant number 29, Lori Menshaus, Miss Ashland area. Contestant number 12, Dana Agee, Miss Richmond area. Contestant number 5, Shanna Moore, Miss Louisville. Contestant number 26, Cheryl Lynn Cook, Miss Southeast Kentucky. Contestant number 18, Elizabeth White, Miss Derby City. And contestant number 22, Heather French, Miss Jefferson County. Ladies and gentlemen, there they are, the 10 semifinalists vying for the title of Miss Kentucky.
Now that we know who our 10 semifinalists are, we would like to point out that these contestants' interview scores, which amount to 30% of the total score, are the only points carried over to tonight's competition. Tonight, each of these young women will be judged in talent competition, which will account for 30% of the score. Evening wear counts 15%, and physical fitness in swimsuit also counts 15%. The top five finalists will then be announced. They will be interviewed on stage by a general question, which will be followed by a question on their individual platform. This will account for 10% of the total score.
Five distinguished judges are here tonight who are charged to make those difficult decisions.
Rick Pruitt's business is finance, but for nearly two decades, he's given his time and talents to the Miss Arkansas pageant, and he's served on judges' panels all over the country.
Susan Eby is a former newscaster and now works in administration at a North Carolina hospital. She previously headed up the Miss Idaho pageant and has judged in 35 states.
Karen Balk is a business owner and active volunteer in her community of Boise, Idaho. She worked with the Miss Idaho pageant for 12 years, serving as a former president.
Joseph P. Sanders III is vice president of the South Carolina Bank. He gives his spare time to many community organizations, but for 38 years, he's devoted himself to the Miss South Carolina pageant.
Gail Bullock Odom was Miss Georgia 1973. She's an accomplished dancer and a former television newscaster. She now owns an advertising agency and has judged pageants in several states.
While only 10 of our contestants will be competing on stage tonight, the remaining 20 women are all winners in their own right. We would like to give you the opportunity to meet 10 of them at this time.
Crazy, I'm crazy for feeling so lonely.
He never got to see us grow up, Mama, all because of him.
You're the best man I've ever known, and there's just no way I'm letting go.
No, 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 no way.
If I could reach higher, just for one moment touch the sky, that one moment in my life.
There was no helpless. Not even a dream. Peace. And at that moment, I realized as a woman how lucky I was.
When we return, we're going to begin our evening wear competition with anticipation of what the night will bring.
Thank you.
Kentucky 1996. Thank you so much. Well, tonight is indeed a magical night for all of our contestants. And now, with an accent on beauty, dedication, and intelligence, we'd like to present now our 10 semifinalists in evening wear. And we will continue in the order in which they were announced. We begin with Ginger Orr, Miss Heart of the Bluegrass.
Thank you.
Elizabeth Wright, Miss Derby City.
Very much winners.
I said blue moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Shine on the one that's gone and left me blue. Ooh, the trees singing weird melodies, so they made that the thought of the blue and
program. So for your entertainment and the consideration, of course, of our judges, now the semifinalists in talent competition for all of us here at Transylvania University and for those of you watching at home. If heartbreak happens in your life, it's always a time of sadness. And sometimes we feel that if we just get a little bit better, if we break down and cry about it. Performing a rendition of Crystal Gayle's classic song, Cry, is Miss Heart of the Bluegrass, Ginger Orr.
Thank you.
is that precious moment when dedication and experience bring about the fulfillment of a dream. Performing a lyrical dance to This Is the Moment from the Broadway musical Jekyll and Hyde is Miss Lexington, Rebecca Nunley. To save my life, and then it works. I love technology.
Robin Littrell, Miss Monticello, thank you very much. Most of you may not know that Kentucky ranks as one of the top states in the Miss America system for giving away in-kind scholarship money. This year, we will be awarding more than $3.8 million to these young women. And since 1991, $28 million has been made available. And we could not do that with wonderful institutions of our state. Thank you so much. Many contestants are performing to music popular long before their birth. So it is with our next contestant performing a tap routine to Tico Tico. Claudia Coffey, Jefferson County.
Revolutionary Etude by Chopin is performed now by Lori Menzhaus, Miss Ashland Area. Thank you. Kentucky Scholarship Program has really been pleased to be helped by the Bryan Station High School ROTC program, the high school located here in Lexington. They're an outstanding group of students. In fact, one of the top ROTC programs in the entire nation. And for, like we said, for the past 4 years, they've been here to help out during our scholarship pageant competition. People who are here at Transylvania University have seen some of the cadets helping this evening, and we wanted to recognize them right now, the Bryan Station ROTC program, for helping out with the Miss Kentucky Scholarship Pageant. We appreciate their efforts. And we continue now with our talent competition. As many of you know, Patsy Cline, of course, one of America's best-loved singers, and here to sing her popular, heartfelt classic, Sweet Dreams, we'd like you to greet Dana Agee, Miss Richmond Area.
Beethoven, the inspiringly beautiful third movement of Moonlight Sonata. Shanna Moore, Miss Louisville.
Thank you.
people of the Gift Piano Center, locations here in Lexington and Louisville, providing the beautiful Steinway piano that you've seen on stage this evening. Technicians from the Piano Center are also providing a tuning each night so that the piano was by this time in top condition for the contestants. So thank you for the use of this beautiful instrument. Moving along in talent competition, if you love something, set it free. If it returns to you, it is yours. If it doesn't, it was never meant to be. Here to perform at this moment is Sherilyn Cook, Miss Southeast Kentucky.
City. Thank you. While we have a moment before we bring out our final talent competitor, we wanted to thank the late Jean Megalee Stivers, Miss Kentucky 1935, and Dr. James Stivers, who is here with us tonight, for the $500 Jean Megalee Stivers Memorial Community Service Award. That's going to be given to a Miss Kentucky contestant who has provided outstanding community service. And as you can imagine, with the terrific group of 30 young ladies we had this year, this was stiff competition. That's going to be awarded at the end of the show, so we look forward to that. We also want to thank Gorel Consulting PSC for the two non-finalist talent awards of $250 each. Those two will be announced this evening. Thanks to Judy Moore for donating the non-finalist interview award of $500. And we want to thank the Elizabeth Weaver Memorial Fund for the $300 piano performance award. Again, all of these will be awarded before the end of our broadcast tonight. Hope, desire, hard work, and belief in yourself and others, it always places you on the winning side of life. Here to sing the winner's circle is Miss Jeffersontown, Heather French.
Do you believe in heroes, people who dare to try? And do you believe in those who won't let my past and mine? And do you believe in dreamers who can dream a dream brand new? Do you believe that you're the one who can make those dreams come true? Thanks, Jeffersontown. This is the place for you. This is the winner's dream that's finally coming true. Don't think the law, the possibilities.
Just think of all the possibilities. The winner's circle.
area. Take your places in front of the stage now once again as we get ready for more exciting announcements.
Now with those three categories and their interview scores carried over, the field will now be narrowed to five. Those five will continue with on-stage interviews. If we could have the top five, please. Not ready yet? Now we are ready. The man who also does my taxes. How is that audit coming, by the way, Mr. Crane? Good? Good. All right. Again, in no particular order, the top five finalists, Claudia Coffey, Miss Jefferson County. Dana A.G., Miss Richmond area. Heather French, Miss Jefferson Town. Cheryl Lynn Cook, Miss Southeast Kentucky. And Rory Minshouse, Miss Ashland area.
Stay with us. We'll be right back with more exciting announcements.
Welcome back. We have our five finalists now for the on-stage interview. We'll ask each contestant a general question. She has 20 seconds to answer, and then we'll ask a more specific question on her platform. Again, 20 seconds to answer, and they will be timed. And we begin with Claudia Coffey. Claudia, why do blondes have more fun, or do they?
Well, I should make a confession here. I'm not a natural blonde, and you're not supposed to tell everybody at home that.
You just told them, not me.
Gosh, you can have fun any color. Please, Tom, let's not tell everybody all my secrets.
All right, thank you. Dana A.G., how did you get involved in the Miss Kentucky scholarship system?
I got involved in the system 4 years ago. This is my fourth year competing in this system. I wanted to compete in the system because the focus was on intelligence and talent and community service, which are all so important to me. And I very much enjoy competing in this system because it's all about self-improvement.
Thank you. Heather French, tell us about one of your most embarrassing moments.
One of my most embarrassing moments happened in high school, actually. I had friends that liked to play a lot of pranks on me, and I was in marching band. And one day I wore a skirt to marching band practice, and one of my friends pulled it up and then ripped the back of the skirt. So all day long I had my shirt hanging to my knees and was tucked in. I would say that would have to be the most embarrassing moment I've ever had.
Thank you. Cherylyn Cook, what is the funniest thing that has happened to you recently?
Recently? The funniest thing that has happened to me recently would have to be falling down the steps when I was just walking backstage, and I just took a big dive, and that was it.
And still alive to tell about it.
Still
we were
alive.
Happy to report.
Hanging in there.
Thank you. Rory Minshouse, what would you do on your ideal date?
My ideal date would have to have a man who's super intelligent, but for me, it would be a moonlit walk at the beach under bright stars with the waves crashing.
Very good. Thank you. Now, remember, our second round of questions deals with the contestants' platform. They have 20 seconds to answer. Claudia, we will begin with you again. How does the kids vote program keep children from just voting the way that their parents do?
The key point of the program is to educate them about voting, to educate them about how to make informed decisions so when they go to the ballot box, they're making a decision for themselves. And we feel honored and proud about that. And I think that's what, when everybody votes, they would be proud to be an American and proud to vote, and that's what the program does.
Thank you. Dana Angie, tell us about your Operation Outreach program for breast cancer.
My Operation Outreach program is what I want to use to help increase public awareness and education and increase access to breast cancer screening methods. It's a mobile unit that would go out into the communities in rural areas, especially where women are underserved, and it would provide both education materials as well as a mammography machine that would be right there, take it to them, and let them be screened for breast cancer.
Thank you. Heather French, tell us what's unique about the Love Hunger program.
So the Love Hunger program is actually started at Southeast Christian Church in Louisville, Kentucky, and it's a support group for victims of eating disorders, and that would be anorexia, bulimia, and compulsive overeating. What's unique is it deals with the emotional side, not just the physical side of eating disorders.
Thank you much. And Cherylyn Cook, tell us about the Always Kids campaign.
Always Kids campaign is a part of the Children's Miracle Network.
that doesn't deal with what we see, that's telethons and the program that helps millions of children in the health area. Always Kids helps children with social programs as well as educational programs. And that's what's so wonderful about it, because you're helping your neighbor's child or you're helping your child in all areas of their life.
Thank you. And Lori Menshaus, should terminal cancer patients be allowed to use drugs that are still being tested by the FDA?
I really believe that they should be, because if you're terminally ill with cancer, you don't have that much left to live for. But you can fight, and as long as there's a hope, and there is hope in cancer drugs that are on research right now, give them that chance, because hope can improve their lives, what their lives they have left.
All right. Ladies, thank you very much. Nancy?
Competition is complete, and up next we'll say farewell to Veronica Duca, Miss Kentucky 1996. Don't go away.
Could have never realized her dream years, Miss Kentucky, without a lot of help. I would like to thank the children of the Kentucky School for helping me to have such an incredible year. You are the true reason I feel I've been successful as Miss Kentucky. I would like to thank the Department of Agriculture. Together we are striving to ensure the health of future generations. To the Miss Kentucky Board, thank you for all of your support and advice and standing by me no matter what, all year. To Libby, Ronnie, Lauren, Ross, Jetta, and Storm, no matter how far away I go or what lies ahead, you will always be my family, and I will never forget what you've done for me. Mom, you're my best friend and my hero. And Granny and Granddad and all of my other family members, I want to thank you for all of your guidance, love, and support. You have made me the young woman I am today. To the community of Campbellsville and my church, I thank you for your support and understanding. Finally, I thank my Heavenly Father who has guided me to this point in my life and trust that His hand will continue to direct my path in the future. Some of the other outstanding talents and achievements of our non-finalists with some special awards.
Our non-finalist talent winners are Tracy Carpenter, Miss Fayette County.
I said blue, blue, blue.
Miss East Kentucky. Our non-finalist interview winner is Brooke Robinson, Miss Paducah area.
Spends many hours in community service to support the platform they have chosen. Now a special award for community service named in honor of an outstanding woman. We have a saying around here, once a Miss Kentucky, always a Miss Kentucky. Well, last year we lost a special member of that family.
She didn't set out to be a pioneer, but Jean Meggerly Stivers was one of the first to step onto the stage and into the spotlight. A spotlight that lit the way for hundreds of young women after her. In 1935, she became Kentucky's first representative in the Miss America pageant, a fact she kept secret from her grandfather.
We had the high-built newspaper from my grandfather.
In the 30s, beauty pageants were scorned by many, but Jean stood proud of the trail she had blazed. As a mother and wife, she continued to serve her community for decades, being named an outstanding Kentuckian and a Kentucky Colonel. 2 years ago, Jean celebrated with dozens of other Miss Kentuckys at our 50th anniversary. She is still remembered for placing higher in the Miss America pageant than any other Miss Kentucky. In 1935, Jean was second runner-up to Miss America, but she will always be remembered as the first here in the Bluegrass.
Spend some time with Miss Stivers. Even then, so much grace and dignity and class. Whether it's 25 or 85 years old, you will always know a Miss Kentucky from a long way away, and that was certainly the case.
Well, here to present the first Jean Meggerly Stivers Memorial Community Service Award is Miss Stivers' son, Dr. James Stivers. And the winner is Robin Littrell, Miss Monticello. It's time now to continue the tradition established by 51 Miss Kentuckys before as we name tonight's runners-up and the new Miss Kentucky.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please welcome to the stage the Lieutenant Governor of the Commonwealth of Kentucky, Dr. Steve Henry. Lieutenant Governor Henry is going to assist in the crowning of Miss Kentucky 1997. That's not bad work if you can get it. Have the judges reached a decision? And we have it now. Very good. Thank you.
The fourth runner-up, the recipient of a $1,500 scholarship sponsored by Harold White Lumber and Millworks, is Claudia Coffey, Miss Jefferson County.
The third runner-up, the recipient of a $2,000 scholarship sponsored by Mr. Jim Elam, is Heather French, Miss Jefferson Town.
The second runner-up, the recipient of a $2,500 scholarship sponsored by J.D. Johnson, is Sherilyn Cook, Miss Southeast Kentucky.
The first runner-up, recipient of a $3,500 scholarship sponsored by John Welch and Carol Makata, is Dana Agee, so your new Miss Kentucky is Lori Menshouse.
she competes in the 1997 Miss America pageant. Congratulations, Lori!